Hello, retro viewers. Thanks for checking in on me. I noticed that I focus a lot more on my gender issues here than I do on my sexuality issues. But since it's Lesbian Visibility Week, I thought maybe I should make an attempt at dwelling on my sexuality issues instead for a moment. If you're new to my channel, I'll try to dumb down my overly complicated situation with gender for you. Basically, I'm a dysphoric woman and happily transition with testosterone and top surgery. That is why I look like a man. I'm socially detransitioned or re-identified as I used to be a trans man. My name is Sara in real life, which is the name that my parents gave me at birth. I'm biologically female and happy about it. I haven't found a label for my situation with gender, but I refer to myself as a male passing woman a lot. I hope that makes sense. Additionally, I'm a lesbian, which I don't talk about nearly as much. I know for sure that I'm homosexual, as in only attracted to people of the same biological sex as myself, even though my past trauma still confused me about it a bit. I do not want for this video to be about the complicated intersection of my traumas and my homosexuality, or about how incel autogynephile trans women on Twitter make me feel like a horrible turfy transphobe for being into dick, but rather about how I'm invisibly lesbian. The concept of lesbian visibility feels relevant to me, because as a male passing woman, not only my womanhood is hidden, but also my lesbian orientation. When people ask me if I'm gay, they're asking if I'm into other men, because for some unknown reason I haven't been able to put my finger on, my beard and deep voice apparently fool people that well. Being invisibly lesbian is both practical and saddening to me. It's practical in the sense that I never have to be scared to show public displays of affection with a same-sex partner. But it's saddening because I feel left out of my own community and ostracized by my own kind. Perhaps it tells them how privileged I am for being sad about something which clearly makes me a less likely target of homophobia. But please allow me to complain about my problems, regardless of how privileged they might seem. Despite my male-passing exterior, I'm not the same as a straight man. My family knows that my attraction to women isn't straight, regardless of what I sound and look like. My girlfriend knows that our relationship isn't straight either. We feel it, we know it. I'm very different in the eyes of a stranger from what I am in the eyes of someone who knows me and my history. My female homosexuality is not lesser just because I look like a man. I could scream from rooftops how very much of a lesbian I am. I could cover my entire body in double Venus signs and Labry symbols. I could even tattoo the word lesbian on my forehead, but I'd still be invisibly lesbian. That hurts. It does. Whenever I see lesbian couples depicted online, I feel like I can intrinsically relate to them, but visually I cannot. I cannot join a lesbian space without either an explanation or having my girlfriend vouch for me. Whenever I've met another lesbian in real life and also said that I'm a lesbian, I've been met with disdain. Privately, I'm a woman who loves other women. I'm my girlfriend's girlfriend. When we make silly jokes about pussy passion and cringe together about how gross dicks are. When I talk about my feelings towards the same sex or when I'm intimate with my girlfriend, there is no doubt on my homosexuality. But outside, among strangers, I'm functionally a straight man. Well, most people would assume I'm a gay man because of my femininity. But no matter what, no stranger sees a lesbian when they look at me. Not even when I hold my girlfriend's hand or kiss her. Not even when I'm dressed super femininely and have my face shaven. Even though my girlfriend is obviously the more dominant and masculine one of us. I mean, she's clearly the man in our relationship. Then we just look like we're straight with extra steps, which honestly feels insulting. choosing to keep my male passing appearance feels a lot like depriving myself of ever being fully out and proud as a lesbian. Like I'm choosing to hide it, but I'm not purposely hiding anything about myself. The real me may not be showing on the outside, but I'm as open about it as I possibly can be in these circumstances. But it still feels like I'm being unintentionally deceptive. It makes me want to reach outside of myself somehow, like reaching my hands outside of my skin, as if my skin is the bars of a cage, and all that people can see is the cage that I'm trapped inside of. Some might say that sounds like I'm dysphoric about looking male, but that isn't really the case. I want to be seen as a woman, and I want to be recognized as a lesbian when I'm with my girlfriend. But I do not actually wish to change my appearance. I do not wish to look like a woman. I already am a woman, regardless of my appearance. And I simply wish that I could be seen as a woman, regardless of my appearance. I think it's fair to say that I feel what you could call social dysphoria over looking male because of my desire to be read as female, but at the same time I also feel what you could call body dysphoria over looking too clearly female because I genuinely feel more comfortable looking like a man, meaning my social dysphoria directly contradicts my body dysphoria, which is kinda hard to live with. Whatever you might wish to call it, the contradictory feelings I have about my body versus how I wish to be seen socially cannot be solved by either transitioning or medically detransitioning. There is no perfect solution for my dilemma, only a weighing of pros and cons and taking the least painful route. Either I could change my body to appear more clearly female, to achieve that lesbian visibility and having my womanhood automatically socially recognized, which I deeply yearn for and crave, but at the heavy price of feeling wrong in my body, or at least more mutilated than I already am. But what about all that time that I spend away from other people, when I only have myself and my body? I've been making myself into a prop for social validation, which goes against everything I believe in. Or, I could stay male passing and be comfortable with my body privately and socially, just in generally more comfortable. I'd feel handsome and alright, at least most of the time, but at the expense of never being seen for who I actually am. The price of that is giving up my lesbian visibility, being recognized as a woman, taking part in female-only spaces, and being pushed to the edges of the lesbian community, which ultimately leads me to having no place where I belong. Those are huge sacrifices. Sometimes that makes me break down. It makes me freak out, panic shave my face, only to regret it later, and cry about how much my life sucks. But I still make that choice, even though it's so fucking painful, because the only other alternative would be even worse. I cannot sacrifice my transition traits, the integrity of my body, for social validation. But just because I'm capable of making that difficult choice, doesn't mean I don't care about my internal identity, which is my truth, or that I don't want it socially recognized. Quite the opposite, I care about it so much. But I stand between the only two options of either sacrificing my identity or my body, which is an impossible dilemma to ever truly solve. But the biggest reason why it's so painful for me to not sacrifice my lesbian visibility for the sake of the integrity of my body is because I was in denial of my sexual orientation for my whole life until after my gender transition. Then I finally accepted and began to embrace that I really am a lesbian, but unable to ever truly show it. That hurts so much. I feel like all the options that I have truly suck, and that all I can do is making compromises. I talk a lot about myself as a woman and lesbian to make up for the fact that I look male, until it makes me feel like an imposter of my own biological sex and of my own innate sexuality. As if I somehow slowly cease to exist as my deceptive appearance takes over, like a virus transforming and ultimately consuming its host. But what remains invisible can still exist. All you gotta do is listen. Thank you for watching.